Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Shall we start? Just I'll put a message on the group. Good afternoon. I can see on the chat box. Yes, we can start. Let me share. I have kept my video off for your convenience, right? I'll share my screen. Okay, so just I'll take 5 minutes to brief what all we have done. So we have seen the introduction of LabVIEW, that it is a graphical user face, graphical user interface. And then we have seen what are the LabVIEW files. They are .vi files. Then you have the .lv project also, LabVIEW projects also, that is another kind of file. And then you have the .ctl file also available, that is the custom control. These three kind of files are there. Then we have seen the main components of VI are nothing but the front panel, block diagram, and the connector pane. These are the, so on the front panel, we have all the controls and indicators. On the block diagram, we will have the terminals of controls and indicators. We will have constants. We will have nodes, which comprises of functions, sub VI. We have some sub VIs, all those. Okay. And then we will also have the wires, the connections also we will have there, okay? Then we have seen the different type of controls and indicators. They can be input devices, knobs, buttons, lights, the input data. What are the different kind of indicators? The output devices, graph, LEDs, and the waveform generator, all that waveform, that chart, graph or chart. Okay, so these kind of. Then we have seen that controls to be of numeric kind, then the vertical or the horizontal slide kind, then knobs, then the Boolean type, all these we have seen. Okay. That we are seeing that, right? Yes, those then indicators also. Then what are the functions? We also have seen the control palette and the functions palette. If you want to locate the controls palette, you have to right click on the front panel. If you want to see the functions palette, you have to right click on the block diagram. Then we have also seen what are the terminals. Terminals are the controls and indicators, or those things we have seen. Nodes, what are those? Nodes are your functions, or you have in the functions you can have addition, subtraction, structures, arrays. All these are called as nodes, which perform some operations. Okay. Then we have seen the wires. Now let us have some more discussion on the wires. Everyone has joined now, so I think we can go ahead. We will save this first. This session we will save. Otherwise, we'll keep this session. Okay. So suppose here, if I want to take a set of values. Suppose I want to calculate the area of a set of values. I will select the array. Okay. I will select the array. Suppose I select this kind of array. Okay. So that is one array. Okay. Suppose I say this is 10. This is the indicator, I think. Let us have array build array. Okay, we'll this array this come here. Okay, and then I'll go to properties. Enable size. Create indicator. think this is we'll see that later. So suppose I make one for loop. Okay. Suppose I make one for loop just for the I run this constant for 10 times, and then there is one add button. Okay. Same thing I will do. Multiply. Control X. It is base. Base 2. Suppose it is create control. This is height 2. Okay. Then this is your create constant 0.5. Okay. And then suppose I take this value out. Now, could you see that everyone followed that what I have done? Now, what this for loop will do? Now, can you tell me what this for loop will do? Anyone can tell me what this for loop will do to us? I have created one for loop which will be running for 10 times. Now, can you make out this these wires? These are very thin wires, na? Okay. So what this for loop will do? This will for loop will be running for 10 times. This for loop will be running for 10 times. Okay. So for each loop, it will be generating the area of triangle for each values. For each values of the base, it will be running and generating the values. Okay. So if I create one indicator here, if I create one indicator, can you see the there is some distinction? Is there any distinction here? What is the type of wire here? What is the type of wire? Thick. Wire is thick, yes or no? Can you see the difference between these two wires? Area of set of, this is set of area of triangle. Okay, so for each values of base and height, it will generate one. See what has happened. This I am this inadvertently I have connected this. Yes or no? Mistakenly. Now how to remove? I have to click here. Then it will keep on moving. Just simply put the escape. Just you see, it is not going now. It will not go now. It will not go. It will get connected elsewhere. This that place, huh? So what you'll have to do, simply put the escape. It will vanish, these connections. Okay. Now you tell me what will happen is this for loop. The for loop, when it is running for the first time, it will take these values. Okay. And if it is running for second time, it will again take the same value. Okay. Now you just see there is some, here it is. This is called as auto-indexed tunnel. This is called as auto-indexed tunnel. Can you see there is some one small in-between groove kind of there, one matrix kind of structures is there inside that. If you look carefully, na, it is some matrix kind of structure is there. Okay, inside that. Now, if you right click on that, there is something that is called as last value indexing concatenating. Concatenating. Okay, what is last value? It will take only the last value of your that of your iteration. And what is indexing? It will take the iteration. It will for the last value. Let me see. Let me show that once more. Let me one have more one connection. Okay, I will here. I'll put last value. Now I will put the indicator. Can you see the difference? Latest area of triangle. Okay, what is the difference between these two wires? One is thick, another one is thin. Could you see? The upper one, the upper one is an one-dimensional array, and the lower one, the lower one is called as a scalar. So it will give you the scalar value, single value. Okay. This is taking the last value, so means single value, it's scalar quantity. Okay, this is what it is doing. This is taking the indexing iteration number as the value, so it will have an array kind of structure. It's not an array kind of structure. We would like to see the latest. Let me put the area of 10, 5, 5. How many are there? First triangle, please. Parallel array or not? Right? Everyone has got the scalar and the
yes, sir.
Okay, so that is one one.
Sir, can you please repeat how did you create the loop?
The loop, you go to the block diagram, right click, go to the structures, got it. Go to
Yes.
the for loop. ठीक है,
Yes, sir.
just put here and then extend it. Keep on your left that click. You keep it pressed and extend it, then like this.
Yes, sir.
See what I can do. I can take this part inside. I can take this part inside. Yes or no?
Yes.
I can take it inside. Yes.
So I didn't get the one dimensional array.
If suppose you suppose you iterate one loop, particular loop, okay, and you want to save the output as well as the iteration number. So what will be the result?
Sir, that is not the thing, sir. Sir, I'm saying that I didn't get the one dimensional array that you have showed us extending that box. I'm not getting that one.
Okay, that you I'll again show you. Okay. Just let me remove this. Everyone has got this. You have this let me just take out this. You had this diagram with you.
Yes, sir.
You had this diagram, and then you had the you had this indicator area under a triangle. What I am
yes,
doing
sir.
On the block diagram, I am right clicking, then I am moving my cursor to structures,
for
then
loop.
I am clicking on the for loop, right?
Mm-hmm.
On the for loop. Now, could you see this? I have not pressed anything. Now I keep my left this mouse click pressed, and then I extend it.
Mm.
Now this has become. Okay, everyone has got this for loop.
Yes, sir.
Now can you remove this indicator? Just you
yes,
remove
sir.
This indicator.
Mm.
Now keep your like this, and this you select like this. Can you make like this?
Yes, sir.
Then you have all selected. Now you move press it, left click on this, press it and drag inside that, inside the box. Done.
Yes, sir.
Now you connect here. Done.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Done. This up to this you have done. Now
yes,
here
sir.
What is happening here, you here if you click auto index tunnel, it is coming by default.
Yes, sir.
Now if you right click on that auto index tunnel, indexing matlab kya, it will take the number, it will remember the iteration number, it will remember the iteration number. I will create constant as 10. Okay. It will remember the iteration number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 till 10. What is the number, right?
Yes,
and
sir.
Then it will keep the output also, iteration number as well as output. Okay. So that can be actually the iteration number is nothing but the position. In the, it is nothing but the position itself. So this value can be saved as a one dimensional array. You need only 1D array to save it, because other dimension is your position itself. Okay, indexing that you are using for the position number. Okay. So here now you, what you do, you right click on this. Can you see this? Right click,
yes.
Create indicator. Now an array has been created. Can you see the thickness of these two wires, the difference? So
yes,
this this value is what? This is a scalar. For a particular base, for a particular height, this will have one value. But what about this array? For all, this array will consist of all the 10 iteration value.
Yes, sir.
So I'll make one more. I can tap it. Then I will put last value. Just you see. tunnel mode last value. Can you see the difference between that? This is the filled one. So means it is taking only the scalar quantity. And this is one inside this, there is a, it is looking like a groove. Actually, there is a symbol of array. If you look closely, na, there is an matrix symbol, right? Matrix
yes,
symbol
yes.
Inside that. Okay. So if I right click there, then create indicator, then this. Can you see? This is thick 1D array. And this is very thin. So this is a scalar quantity. Right? Let me run this. Now just see. I have run this. So what is this down numeric? It is giving me a 25. Only one value. Okay? And what is this array is giving me? It is giving me 0, 25. Now this 0, you can see now the white background 0, that on the array, this one array I'm showing on the front panel. Can you see, all of you? So let me increase this to 1. What is the value? 25. So this will give till go till suppose 9. What is the value? 25. What about 10? 0. Actually, they start the indexing from 0. Here it is 0 to 9, right? 10 iteration is 0 to 9. All will have the same value because base and height are constant for each iteration. It will have same area. Okay? So that is one way of representing like this. If I will extend this, you just see, I will extend this. Can you see it is visible to you?
Yes, sir.
So all the elements now thereafter it is coming 0 0. I can extend it, keep on extending it, but it will come after this. This is fainted gray color, that it is showing that there is the main array is still that 25 only. Okay, so you can see that this is one dimensional array, right? So what I am saying that in the wire can take different values. Like I said, if it is orange color, if it is orange color, what is the data type? Floating point. Floating point. Okay. If it is a blue color, what is the data type? Integer. If it is green color, what is the data type? Boolean. And if it is a pink color, what is the data type? It is a string, or it is a string type. Okay, right? It is a string type. Now if the wire is thin, then what is the value type? Scalar. If there is a thick wire, single thick wire, then what is the type? 1D scalar. And suppose you want to do the 2D 1D array. 1D array is this. This array is a 1D array. Suppose you are representing the two-dimensional array, then how it will show? It will show two thick parallel lines. It will show two thick parallel lines together, right? So you can make out that what is the shape, what is that type of data. It is a scalar, it is 1D array, or it is 2D array. Everyone has got this, that what kind of data type you are expecting, what kind of value you are expecting, right?
Tell about this tunnel thing again.
Tunnel. In the lab view, when you come out of a loop, you can have two possibilities. Either you save on the only the last value, okay, just preceding value, when the last execute loop executed. or you can save on all the values the loop has executed. Generally, these two are the possibilities, na? General possibilities are what? Either you save on the last possible value, or you can save the all the possible values. We will see some more instances. ठीक है? ऐसा होता है ना? दो ही तो होते हैं ना? ठीक है? तो इसमें क्या किया कि that here for each loop iteration there will be one output. So suppose you want to only save that whatever the scalar value it has for each loop iteration it is creating. तो इसमें क्या होगा? ये numeric में क्या होगा? It will save only the last value and it will override the previous one. Override the previous one. मतलब पांच इटरेशन पहले इसमें क्या था इन इस न्यूमेरिक को पता नहीं चलेगा. आपको पता चलेगा क्या? आपको नहीं चलेगा इसमें न्यूमेरिक में, बिकॉज इट हैज ओवर रिटन दैट वैल्यू. बट इन द एरे व्हाट विल हैपन? यू कैन हैव ऑल द स्टोर्ड वैल्यूज विच द लूप हैज एग्जीक्यूटेड, राइट? Again, I will tell you, see, just I am connecting here. See, it is.
Sir,
not...
if you don't mind, can you just repeat the whole thing from first quickly? Means,
I am showing you the that I have told you the data type. Data type is that floating, integer, boolean, and string, right? I wanted to show you also what you can have scalar data quantity, you can have one dimensional data quantity, or you can have two dimensional data quantity. ठीक है? Yes or no? Now what is a scalar data quantity? It will give a single value. For a particular input, base and height, what this this area will be unique, right? This area will be have only one value. Okay, so that this numeric it is taking for each it is executing one. But suppose I want to have for each iteration. Suppose in this case I have kept my base and height to be constant for each iteration. But suppose they are varying. I could have made it variable also, na? I'm not doing right now. ठीक है? But suppose it is varying, then what will happen? This area will be changing. This array, the area is stored under the array will change for each iteration. So that that will be all the areas will be mentioned in the array. All the areas will be mentioned in the array.
Sir, may I know which array did you choose, sir? Means in array tab?
I'll just show you this.
And also that means n connected to 10. These are both things I still did not get, sir.
This is structures I have gone. I have right click on the this.
Yes, sir.
If a for loop will have what? A for loop requires what? It requires number of iterations you need to execute the loop, right?
Yes, sir.
So on the this n is the number of this is loop count. You can you see this loop count?
Yes, sir.
I will right on the outer side. You will right click on that. So what it is saying? Create constant. I have
yes,
created
sir.
Constant 10. Right?
Yes, done, sir.
Done. And then what I am doing, I am taking it inside. I am making one replica. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Done. Now
yes, sir.
You just tell me for each loop iteration, what will be the value? Create indicator here. What will be the value here? Will it be a constant or not? For if I execute this loop, the down one, for each loop, this value will be coming constant. Yes or no? this value, it will have particular value. Now, instantaneous value, you know, na, in engineering, if for the instantaneous base and height value, the area value will be this base into height divided by 2. Yes, base into height divided by 2. But suppose base and height are variable and I want to save that for each iteration. What I'll do, I'll go here. Okay. Now you just see, if I have connected this, I'm taking this value out of the loop. I have been allowed two cases. Either I can take the value, only the last value out of the loop, or I can take the total values out of the loop. Okay. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
देखो मैं दोनों कनेक्ट कर देता हूँ, ये भी कनेक्ट कर देता हूँ, ये देखो यहाँ से ये भी कनेक्ट कर दिया, ठीक है? अब
yes,
ये
sir.
देखो दोनों सिमिलर है. व्हाट आई हैव डन, दिस इज ऑटो इंडेक्स टनल, दिस इज ऑटो इंडेक्स टनल, दिस इज लैब व्यू बाय डिफॉल्ट गिव्स दिस, ठीक है?
सर, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ ऑटो इंडेक्स टनल सर?
ऑटो इंडेक्स मतलब इन द इटरेशन जीरो you have the value, the output of the loop. Indicator. अभी मैं बता दे रहा हूँ, ठीक है? When the loop first time executes, then what is the output? ठीक है? You are storing that on the position zero. When the loop executes second time, one, then what is the output? That loop is storing that. ठीक है? So you just see what I am saying here. What I am saying, I am just concerned about the last value. So can you see the difference between these two? ये दोनों के बीच, ये यहाँ पे, यहाँ जो मैं दिखा रहा हूँ राइट एंड पे, वन इज फिल्ड एंड अदर वन इज हैविंग सम एरे, सम मैट्रिक्स इनसाइड द स्मॉल दैट स्क्वायर. ये वाला जो ये राइट साइड में मैं दिखा रहा हूँ ना, वेर on the bottom that block diagram, ye dikh raha hai. So just this one, this has filled, it is taking only the last possible last value only. Theek hai, it is taking only, so it is a scalar quantity, it is taking only, keeping only one value. But here what is happening, it is keeping the total values. It is keeping the total values, ठीक है? अच्छा, एक बात बताओ. When this numeric value will be available and when this array 2 will be available? अच्छा, एक काम करते हैं. आपको ऐसे नहीं समझ में आ रहा है ना? आप एक काम देखिए. अभी सबका value 0 0 है. ये देखो नीचे आ गया ना ये. I have not executed my loops, right? Now can you see that what is the value of this numeric 2? What is the value of this numeric 2? You see, it is 0. इसको अलग रखो, ठीक है? इसका वैल्यू कितना है देखो, ये कितना है? 0 है. दिस इज अनट्रू ना, बिकॉज व्हाई दैट सो, बिकॉज आई हैव नॉट एग्जीक्यूटेड द लूप, राइट? व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस? 0. एंड व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस? अब एक काम करते हैं, इफ इन ऑर्डर टू शो यू द एग्जीक्यूशन, लेट मी पुट सम टाइमर हियर, ठीक है? लेट मी पुट सम वेट इनसाइड दैट, ठीक है? यहाँ पे suppose I put some create constant here, you have to give some weight. Suppose I give 2000. What is it? Is weight, it is what it does, it before it executes the loop, it will wait for this many milliseconds. So how many milliseconds it is waiting? 2000. 2000 matlab kitna, millisecond matlab kitna, 2 second na. So let me execute now. Just you can you keep an eye of here? Can you keep an eye here?
सर
यहाँ पे कितना आ रहा है, ये एक्स वाई कौन सा है, ये वाला है ना, ये
सर
देखना, ये 2 सेकंड के बाद ही आ जाएगा ये वैल्यू, ये वाला कब आएगा ये देखना, और ये कब आएगा ये देखना, ठीक है। नाउ
ओके
लेट
सर
मी एग्जीक्यूट। ये वाला आ गया ना एक्स वाई, बट
यस सर
अदर अदर थिंग्स हैव कम टिल नाउ, इट विल कम आफ्टर 20 सेकेंड्स। बोथ न्यूमेरिक टू एंड एरे टू वैल्यूज विल कम आफ्टर 20 सेकेंड्स। इट हैज कम नाउ। गॉड, डिड यू गेट दिस और नॉट?
एक्चुअली नो सर. सर हाउ डिड यू मीन्स इज इट मीन्स डज इट ऑटोमेटिकली टेक दैट टाइमिंग सर विच यू जस्ट सेट राइट नाउ.
No, see, if I'll remove this timing, what will happen? It will take the it will, if suppose I remove this timing, right? Then how much time this loop will take to execute? It will take 10 iterations and a 10 clock cycles. And what is the clock cycle? Some nanosecond or something like that in terms of for a 3 gigahertz processor or 2 gigahertz processor, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So can you see the difference? Can you locate the difference, how the loop is functioning? No, na. For that only, I have intentionally kept some timing here. Ki if once this loop has to be executed, how much time? 10 times. So when it has executed first time, after that, just see, I will keep this as 5000. This I will keep as 5000. मतलब कितना? 5000 मतलब कितना? मिलीसेकंड मतलब 5 seconds. And I will change this height to 10. What is the area it should come? This area should come how much instantaneously? How much it will come?
50-50
50 आएगा ना, तो ये देखना, ये तो आ जाएगा 5 सेकेंड के बाद, लेकिन ये दोनों कब आएंगे? एरे टू एंड न्यूमेरिक टू, व्हेन दे विल कम? दीज टू वैल्यूज विल बी अवेलेबल ओनली वंस द लूप एग्जीक्यूट्स, वंस द लूप एग्जीक्यूट्स फुली। लेट मी जस्ट रन, लेट मी रन ओनली
मिन्स
फॉर फाइव फाइव आइट्रेशंस। देखो ये आ गया, तुमने देखा 5 सेकंड के पहले ही ये चेंज हो गया।
यस सर
हाँ, लेकिन ये देखो, ये 25 से 25 सेकंड के बाद चेंज होगा, न्यूमेरिक टू और एरे टू, देख लेना। इट हैज चेंज नाउ आफ्टर 25 सेकंड।
यस सर
अब देखो इसमें ये 50-50 आ रहे हैं, ये आ रहे टू, सारा अपडेट हो गया है। अब इसमें ना कुछ 25-20, ये बाकी सब 0 आ गए, ठीक है। ये देखो, नाउ इट हैज शोइंग ओनली द 5 एलिमेंट्स, यस और नो?
सर
तो व्हाट इज द ऑटो इंडेक्स टनल इज, ऑटो इंडेक्स टनल, इट विल गिव यू द इंडेक्सिंग पोजिशन एंड इट विल गिव यू द वैल्यू एंड द लास्ट वैल्यू। व्हाट इट विल गिव यू? इट विल जस्ट गिव यू द लास्ट वैल्यू, राइट? तो व्हाट आई एम शोइंग यू, दैट अपर वन इज योर, यू कैन मेक आउट द थिक फ्रॉम द थिकनेस ऑफ द वायर, दिस इज एन एरे डेटा टाइप, एंड फ्रॉम द लोअर वन, दैट थिन वायर, यू कैन मेक आउट दिस इज स्केलर डेटा टाइप, ठीक है? दिस यू कैन मेक आउट। एंड इफ यू आर टेकिंग दीज टू पैरेलल लाइन, सपोज दिस वन लाइन लाइक दिस एंड अदर वन इज ऑल्सो लाइक दिस, टू पैरेलल लाइन्स इन दिस, ठीक है, अनदर पैरेलल लाइन लाइक दिस, ठीक है? सो व्हाट विल हैपन? टू पैरेलल थिक लाइन्स इज व्हाट? टू डायमेंशनल एरे, दैट इज ए टू डायमेंशनल एरे, दैट विल सी लेटर। एनीवे, लेट अस मूव लिटिल बिट अहेड।
How did you connect the array to the loop?
I will again do this on the I have lot of that na. I will do the while loop case structure, then you will understand that.
Okay, sir, just one query. Means I am ingesting both, sorry, I am getting both the lines, means array lines, that is, I am getting both the dark lines. I don't know why. And
have you made this thin, that loop tunnel, have you converted? Can you highlight this smaller one, this one? Can you see that I have highlighted this smaller, this?
How to convert it, sir?
No, just you see my cursor is where auto index tunnel. Can you see?
Yes, sir.
Can you right click on that?
Yes, sir.
Can you go to tunnel mode?
Yes, sir.
What is the ticking indexing? It is coming.
In just a minute, sir.
Is it coming indexing? A tick on the indexing.
Indexing is selected, sir. Yes, sir.
Now can you click on the last value?
Last value.
Now just you see when I have converted this to last value. Can you see the difference? What it is saying? Why this broken lines are coming? Because the value is what? After the last value, here what is the value at the loop tunnel? The value here is a single value, right? But what is the array wants? Array wants position as well as the value. Two values it is they want. The coordinates they want. Yes or no? So that is why this there is a mismatch here. So this you can see this has all highlighted. This has an error. This is an error here. So I have to remove this array. Now I will have to connect one. I will have to connect. You just see create one indicator. It will be normal numeric indicator. Got it or not? Got it or not? The normal numeric indicator. Now how to change that? Again, I will put my cursor there, tunnel. I will right click, tunnel mode, and I'll click on the indexing. Now you just see, when I have converted this to auto indexed tunnel, then what is the indicator type they are expecting here? Once I have converted this to auto index tunnel, what is the data type they are in they are expecting here? They are expecting array. That to be array. Okay. So the numeric, it is saying that there is a wrong connection here. Okay. So you have to remove this. You have to remove it. Okay. And then you'll have to select create indicator. You have to create it. This you just see. Is there any error now? There is no error now. Right?
Got it, sir. Thank
Got
you.
Got it? Okay. Anyway, so.
Hello.
Hello. Huh.
Sir, can you demonstrate how in the array we can have different values? Because the array and the last value of.
I'll show you that now. This for loop I have done. Na? So we'll go further. I have already shown you this date conversion of the data type. Suppose this is you have got na? What are the data types? Those see here. If I convert, go to I click on this. This is one numeric. I go to properties, and here the data type. Data type I go, the representation. If I'll change to I32, Is there any some change? Can you see that it has converted to blue? Now the one dot has come up here. Can you see this one dot, red dot in this area at the product side? Can you see here? One red dot has come up here at the base 2 connection. Here it has come up, right? So it kya ho gaya? Now this is one, it is taking one floating type and it is taking another integer type. So there is a mismatch. So that it is showing by a red dot. Let us move forward. You will have lot of examples on the auto indexing of the tunnel. ठीक है, एनीवे यू कैन ऑलवेज ये देखो, ये आप देखिए, दिस लूप काउंट, द लूप काउंट, द लूप काउंट, कैन इट बी, कैन यू सी दिस लूप काउंट? इट इज इन द ब्लू कलर. एन, व्हाट इज द कलर अराउंड एन? ब्लू ना. कैन यू मेक इट फ्लोटिंग पॉइंट? नो ना. So that is why it is in blue color. If you click here, loop count, create constant. So it has to be, I cannot put 10.1 here. It will not take. Okay? It will not take the that floating point values. Right? And one more thing that go to just string. String control. Can you see this? What is the string? Just I'll write our workshop lab view. Okay. Now you have to see that, na? Hello.
Hello.
Huh?
The screen show. Okay.
Now I'm doing very slowly actually. We'll do slowly then. Okay. I'll not move fast. LabVIEW 1 is there. If I run it, what should be the in the string to LabVIEW 1? Could you see that? Now could you see that color? Could you see the color of a string? So, pink color, huh? Huh? Raghav? Is it Raghav? Okay, now we will go to next is while loop and for loop. We will see. What is the difference between while loop and for loop? What is the difference between while loop and for loop?
While loop will at least run once.
While loop will run at least once. I think that is very nice. If you have to, while loop can run infinite number of times till the condition is being met. Till the condition is being met. Okay. So let us make, let us add two numbers. Let us add numbers x and y. And when their sum becomes, greater than,
No.
the background.
Yes, I have muted everyone. I have muted everyone. Let us find when the sum becomes greater than some value, then we'll stop that. So go to the block diagram, go to the structures, and then click on the while loop. Okay, click on the while loop. Can you see that this is go to the structures, go to the block diagram, right click, go to the structures, click on the while loop. Okay, and then extend it. Right. Now, do you see that I have made two while loops? Do you see that I have made two while loops? What I'll do, I'll click on the top one. I'll right click on the edges. Now, just you see, replace with for loop. Can you see that? Replace with for loop. And the, I have converted the while loop to the for loop. Okay. Now you just see the number distinction between for loop and the while loop. In both, the iteration number is being given. In both, this iteration number is being given in both the loops. In the for loop, you have the loop count given. And in the while loop, there is a, by default, there is some loop condition is given. Okay. So we'll see that. The loop condition, if you'll see this loop condition, if you right click, stop if true. It is, it says that stop if true. So red, it can be like continue if true. Can you see that? What is the, it has changed. Right click on this loop condition. Okay. Presently, it is continue if true. It is a green color, a one arrow, rotating arrow. And stop if true, it has become a one famous that is stop that sign, right? Now, let us see that suppose we add something. Suppose we add, create one control X, okay, and create one indicator inside that, create one indicator inside. Now what you will do, we'll connect this I, that loop iteration number, na, the loop iteration number you will connect here. You can also see the value. You can also, if you want to see the value, create indicator here. Okay. Now the currently this is broken. This the errors. Why that is broken? Because this while loop, nothing is there. So let me remove that. The here that that is not, I think the number of loops count was not given. So suppose it is 5. Suppose I am giving 5. Let me put some weight here so that you will know how this being executed. So I'll put some create constant. Maybe I'll put some 3000 second. Okay. I'll put some initial value of X as maybe 5. Can you tell me what are the values? What will be the values for next 5 iterations? The I, this, can you see this I index? This you can see the I. this value goes from 0 to n minus 1. This value goes from 0 to n minus 1, right? So now you just see this will be the, what will be the values and this numeric. Okay. So this numeric we can put here. And this output we can put here. Okay, let us see that how this. Can you see the numeric has started with 0? Then it has become 1, then 2, then 3, then 4. Then it will stop. Okay, at 4. Is it clear, everyone? Is it clear? Can you kindly confirm? For loop, it is clear to everyone.
Yes,
sir. Could you repeat it once again? This is short summary.
Short summary is that first you go to the block diagram. For loop you run for a finite number of times, right? So if you have to, you want any loop for a finite number of times, so you choose a for loop. Now just you see at the edges, these edges you just see. Can you see a page kind of a structure, flipping page? Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
So it means that these are having the finite number of loops, you just see. And let me just put parallelly for the while loop. Can you see a thick continuous structure?
Yes, sir.
If you stack infinite number of pages, one above the other, do you find any difference? You will find almost them to be continuous, na?
Yes, sir.
So that is this is the prime difference between the for loop and you can make out. Just you see on the edges that okay. This is a flip kind of, you know, that pages kind of that structure. And here it is continuous in the while loop, because this while loop can go infinite number of times till the condition is met. If the condition is always true, it will run continuously forever. It will never stop. Okay, so this is the prime difference between them. So for time being, what I am doing, I'm removing this while loop. Let us concentrate on the for loop. So for loop is what you have the loop count, that you give a loop count, that how many times you want the loop to run. So inside this I index is your loop iteration. Inside that is a loop iteration, right? So what I have done, I have made one simple addition. So where I'm giving X as input and I iteration, I'm giving another to that same sum. And what I want with each loop iteration, it will increment by one actually. Why? Because the loop iteration increments by one after every iteration. Okay, so that is only the logic. Let me just change this to 10. Now, can you tell me this value, what will be the value? Initially, it will start with, just see, 10. Then it will go to 11. Then it will become 12. You just see this iteration is changing and this summation is also changing by the same amount.
Okay.
Why I have put this timer, you just see this. If I remove this timer, just you see, if I remove this timer and I put the value 50, in no time it will become 54.
Mm-hmm.
It has become 54. Could you see any difference?
No, you sir, we won't.
Because the 5 iteration is 5 nanosecond or 5 microsecond at maximum. For the lab view, so 5 microsecond, can we make out of it? No, na. So that is the reason we had for to demonstrate how the loop functions. So what we have done, this we have put this timer, this create constant. Okay. Now, where this functionality will come? Can you tell me where this functionality will come? Loop. Suppose you have to collect the data continuously or for a finite number of times. then what you will do, you'll put the DAC inside loop, and it will do, you will run the loop that many number of times. Now you know that the data, you know, there is a called sampling in the engineering, that what is the frequency, at which frequency, if you keep on collecting the data at 1 microsecond interval,
the interval time.
That sampling interval between the two samples, the interval between two samples, when you are doing the collections of the data, if you keep on collecting the data at 1 microsecond interval, what will happen? In 1 second, you'll have 1 million of data. What to do with that data? Okay. You will process only the reasonable amount, because your processor also needs certain time to compute. Yes or no? So particularly if you will work in the process industries, na, that electrical engineers are very fascinated about the timing, electrical and electronics engineers, they work in nanosecond and microsecond. Na, microsecond ke niche to jaate hi nahi hai, soch bhi nahi sakte. Theek hai? But if you'll go to a process industry, can you mix two chemicals in nanosecond?
No, sir.
No, when the 10,000 gallons of chemicals are there, and you will have to stir it, and you'll have to mix two chemicals, you cannot do in microsecond, even you cannot do in millisecond. There you have to take the data in terms of seconds, sometime 5 seconds, sometime 10 seconds. Okay, so these intervals you'll have to keep. So these loop timing will be useful that time.
Okay.
ठीक है. Anyway, ये तो समझ में आया ना कैसे लूप एग्जीक्यूट कर रहा है, आप लोगों ने देखा ना, ये तो समझ में आ गया ना. Let us see
yes.
for the now let us see for the while loop. Then I'll keep that as it is. Let us keep for a while loop. For while loop, we'll keep one condition. When the number becomes maybe something, I'll bring it the same thing. ये बना ही लेते हैं. ये मान लो एक while loop एक करो, आप सब करो मेरे साथ. Go to the block diagram, right click, go to the structures, click on the while loop. किया? While loop आ गया सबका. Inside you go to the numeric, go to the add. ठीक है, add में आ जाओ. ठीक है, now create one constant. मान लो, sorry, not constant, control, I'm sorry, create one control. यहां मान लो x2 रख दिया. Connect this I again to the same thing. Create one indicator here so that you'll keep track of what is happening. Create one indicator. Indicator 2 is the name of this. Okay. And create one indicator here. Create one indicator here also. Okay. Now, let us say, if the sum becomes greater than 20, then you stop. ठीक है, तो go to right click, go to the comparison. ठीक है, greater than चाहिए. ठीक है, ये देखो, अब इसमें जरा देखना पड़ेगा. ये देखो इसमें क्या है. X, this is one comparison, right? This is, you just see X. Can you see, this is on the top, it is X, and on the bottom it is Y. And what is the output? X greater than Y. So matlab X is what? Maan lo X maine isko connect kar diya. Theek hai? Ab Y pe maine maan lo क्रिएट कॉन्स्टेंट कर दिया, 20 कर दिया. ठीक है, सो इफ वंस योर एक्स दिस समेशन बिकम्स ग्रेटर देन 20, दिस विल स्टॉप. एंड इसको क्या किया, ये देखो, Can you see the what kind of this connection is? कैसा कनेक्शन है एक कंपैरिजन का आउटपुट व्हाट इज द आउटपुट ऑफ द कंपैरिजन इट इज अ बुलियन ओनली ना ट्रू और फॉल्स
बुलियन सॉर्ट ऑफ
हाँ इट इज बुलियन ओनली इट इज नेवर ए न्यूमेरिक इट इज इधर ट्रू और फॉल्स तो व्हेन दिस लूप कंडीशन यू सी स्टॉप इफ ट्रू तो इफ दिस This will become greater than this summation will become greater than 20. This will stop. Again, I am putting one timer. I'll show you how this is functioning. Create constant. I'll put it 3 seconds again. ठीक है. ऊपर वाले को हटा ही देते हैं ताकि आपको दिखे पूरा. And न्यूमेरिक यहाँ रख देते हैं एक्स टू यहाँ रख देते हैं दिस इज आई कीप हियर ठीक है जस्ट यू सी आई कैन नॉट एडिट द वैल्यू ऑफ न्यूमेरिक टू एंड द इंडिकेटर एक्स प्लस वाई बट आई कैन एडिट हियर द ये देखो मैंने 10 लगा दिया अब कितना आएगा देखिए आप लोग इट इज स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम 10 11 it has gone 12 13 14 15 16 17 20 पे भी नहीं रुकेगा 21 होगा तब रुकेगा 18 19 20 21 अब इस बार रुक जाएगा नेक्स्ट इटरेशन में रुक गया ना तो व्हाट हैपेंड व्हेन इट हैज डिटेक्टेड द समेशन हैज बिकम ग्रेटर देन 20 देन इट हैज आल्सो अगेन रन फॉर 3 मोर सेकंड्स यस और नो एंड देन इट फाउंड दैट कंडीशन टू बी ट्रू Then it found the condition to be true. ये समझ में आया सबको while loop?
Yes, sir.
तो ये अब देखो एक मैं एक ये दिखा देता हूँ एक मिनट कि मैं control Z मैंने किया I wanted my things back तो मैंने क्या किया मैंने control Z किया I have again got ठीक है अब नाउ जस्ट सी इफ आई वांट टू टेक द आउटपुट फ्रॉम हियर ये मैं इसके बाहर निकालता हूँ ठीक है कैसा आया ये ऑटो इंडेक्सिंग है मैं यहां से भी निकालता हूँ ठीक है ठीक है See that by default here, by default दोनों में देखा आपने by default यहाँ पे क्या लिया इसने for loop में क्या कनेक्ट किया ये default किया ना इन लोगों ने I have not done anything I have just connect, I'm trying to connect here ठीक है तो यहाँ पे इन्होंने क्या किया by default is they will put one indexing ठीक है default it is they will put one indexing And here by default it is loop tunnel. Okay, but I can change it. There is no problem. Okay, I can change here also. Last value. Done. अच्छा ये देखो आप लोग देखो ये मान लो आपने for loop बना दिया आपसे गलती हो गई, तो व्हाट इज दैट, यहाँ पे क्या किया, ये फॉर लूप है ऊपर वाला, आई राइट क्लिक, यहाँ पे क्या किया, आई विल रिप्लेस विथ फॉर लूप, यहाँ रिमूव फॉर लूप हट गया, रिमूव फॉर लूप में क्या किया, फॉर लूप चला गया, ये कांस्टेंट रह गया, आई सब चले गए, सारे कनेक्शन से हो गए, ठीक है। एनीवे सपोज आई हैव टू रिप्लेस दिस विद व्हाइल लूप, क्या हुआ, सारे कनेक्शंस रहे, दिस हैज बिकम एक्स्ट्रा, दिस यू कैन डिलीट, यस और नो, गॉट इट। सपोज यू वांट टू चेंज बिटवीन टू लूप्स, हाउ टू चेंज इट, ठीक है। सो व्हाट इज द कंपैरिजन बिटवीन फॉर लूप एंड व्हाइल लूप इज दैट फॉर लूप विल एग्जीक्यूट अ सेट नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स एंड दिस व्हाइल लूप विल स्टॉप विल बी स्टॉप एग्जीक्यूटिंग ओनली इफ द वैल्यू एट द कंडीशन टर्मिनल मीट्स द कंडीशन, ठीक है। एंड द फॉर लूप कैन एग्जीक्यूट जीरो नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स बट दिस व्हाइल लूप विल एग्जीक्यूट एटलीस्ट वंस टू चेक द कंडीशन, ठीक है। सो टाइमिंग ऑल्सो आई हैव शोन यू दैट टाइमिंग, लेट अस नाउ लेट अस हैव सम फीडबैक इन द लेट अस हैव सम फीडबैक इन योर दिस in your system, okay, let us have some feedback, ye hata do maan lo sab hata do, keep it clean, go to structures, feedback, you know where is the use of you remember there are dynamic sequence, have you studied ye derivative aap logon ne find out kiya hai dy by dt,
yes sir
what's the definition of the derivative dy by dt,
yes sir,
kya tha simplest to mein kiya tha na,
yes sir, differentiation with respect to time,
yt was the yk was the kth sample minus yk minus 1, that was k minus 1th instant sample divided by delta t, where delta t was the sampling duration between the two samples. So yk minus yk minus 1 divided by delta t, where delta t tends to 0, where delta t was tending towards 0. Now your yk is your kth instant sample, then what is yk minus 1, just the preceding sample, that is just the preceding sample, right? That now if you will work in the engineering domain and you want the prediction, if you will work in the engineering domain and you want the prediction, so आप लोगों ने ये सब तो पढ़ा ही होगा दैट इन ऑर्डर टू प्रेडिक्ट द फ्यूचर व्हाट यू हैव टू नो, यू हैव टू नो द पास्ट वैल्यूज, वो कृष्ण देखा था कि नहीं, वो दैट प्रोफेसर आर्या ने क्या किया, ही हैज टर्न द क्लॉक बैक, लेकिन ही वॉज नॉट नोइंग द फ्यूचर इज ऑलरेडी देयर ना, ही कैन नॉट चेंज द फ्यूचर, ही कैन ओनली सी दैट फ्यूचर, ठीक है। एनीवे तो मैं ये बता रहा था कि आपको दैट इन द मेनी टाइम इन द डायनेमिक एनालिसिस यू इफ यू वांट टू कैलकुलेट वाई के यू शुड नो yk-1 yk-2 yk-3 द प्रीवियस सैंपल्स आल्सो वी शुड नो, ठीक है। सो लेट अस सी दैट हाउ वी कैन डू दैट, so go to the structures, go to the for loop and make one, okay, so keep the number of loops to be, suppose create constant to be 5, all of you do along with me, done, this portion is done for all of you, now put one numeric addition, you put one numeric addition at one end, you put one create constant, मान लो फाइव टू रख दो, ठीक है. द अदर एंड यू कनेक्टेड टू ऐसे कनेक्ट मत करो, अभी ऐसे ही रहने दो, ठीक है. अदर वन एंड यू कनेक्ट. नाउ यू जस्ट सी हियर, यू जस्ट राइट क्लिक ऑन हियर राइट एज. यहां पे एक दिख रहा है एड शिफ्ट रजिस्टर. How to get it, I'll again tell you. You go to the right edge, go to the right edge, right click, add shift register. Can you see? ये यहाँ ऐसे press कर दीजिए. आपको आया? सबको आया ये add shift register? आ गया. तो दिस इज शिफ्ट रजिस्टर. कैन यू सी दिस इज शिफ्ट रजिस्टर. तो दिस वैल्यू हियर ऑन द राइट एज इट विल गिव यू वाई के, एंड हियर दिस विल गिव यू व्हाट, वाई के माइनस वन. दिस विल गिव यू व्हाट, वाई के माइनस वन. तो इसको ऐसे कनेक्ट कर दो, इसको ऐसे आप कनेक्ट कर दीजिए. And from after that you connect this to here. Let us what is the create indicator. Create indicator. You this is your YK, this is your YK minus one. So when you are running the loop for the first time, when you are running the loop for the first time, this will give you part, you know. So machine model you in initial value by default you want it. Will take the last value. It will take the last value. So that will be anything. It will start with 0. 0. With the value, and it will be the first value here. Suppose this value is 0. What? So what will be the summation? 2, right? 2. So that 2 will come in the next iteration on the left edge, because this will become yk minus 1 na, after that. So next iteration, what will be the value here on the right edge? Previous 2 plus now 2.
4. 4.
After third iteration, what will be the value? The 4 will be initialized here. What will be the value? 6. Like that. तो उससे पांच बार होगा तो कितना होगा, 10 आएगा ना. ये देखिए आप, ये देखिए 10 आ गया ना. आपको पता नहीं चला ना, क्योंकि इसमें टाइमिंग नहीं था, मैं भूल गया टाइमिंग देना. मैं अभी आपको दिखाता हूँ. दैट क्रिएट कॉन्स्टेंट, ठीक है. I'll put some other value. I'll put 5, right? तो अब मैं करता हूँ. अब देखिए यहाँ पे आपको द वैल्यू विल बी इंडिकेटेड एट द एंड. आई लव व्हाट सी दिस न्यूमेरिक विल बी अवेलेबल व्हेन द लूप एग्जीक्यूट्स. सो इफ यू वांट टू सी द ईच वैल्यू देन यू शुड पुट वन इंडिकेटर इनसाइड दैट, ठीक है. यहाँ अंदर मैंने डाल दिया, ठीक है. अब ये दिस वन विल बी इंडिकेटेड वन बाई वन. यू जस्ट सी दैट इट इज शोइंग 5, गॉट इट, देखा आप लोगों ने? अच्छा व्हाट इज द वैल्यू हियर नाउ, 25 है ना, यहाँ पे लास्ट वैल्यू कितना है 25, राइट। अब इसको मैं रन करूंगा ना तो दिस विल बी इनिशियलाइज्ड टू 25, देखो 30 हो गया ना, देखा आप लोगों ने? तो इसके लिए क्या करते हैं ना, इसको इनिशियलाइज कर देते हैं हमेशा, क्रिएट कांस्टेंट जीरो से इनिशियलाइज। अब आप इसको कितने भी बार रन कीजिए आपको वही वैल्यू आएंगे, 25 ही आएगा हमें हमेशा। एक रन किया, अब दूसरी बार फिर रन करता हूं, ठीक है, समझ में आया? अब नाउ सो दिस वैल्यू इज गिविंग यू yk, y दिस वैल्यू इज गिविंग यू yk ऑन द राइट एज, एंड दिस वैल्यू इज गिविंग यू yk माइनस 1। सपोज यू वांट yk माइनस 2, तो क्या करना है, यहां पे जाके एड एलिमेंट। कैन यू सी दैट व्हाट हैज हैपेंड? देखो ये, देखो सब ये अच्छे से देखो, सॉरी रिमूव एलिमेंट, ठीक है। ये क्या है, राइट एलिमेंट पे yk है, ये क्या है yk माइनस 1 है। सपोज यू वांट yk माइनस 2, तो यू विल पुट एड एलिमेंट, सो द डाउन वन विल बी yk माइनस 2, द टॉप वन विल बी yk, ठीक है। तो लेट अस ऑल्सो इनिशियलाइज दिस विथ जीरो, क्रिएट कॉन्स्टेंट जीरो, ठीक है, जस्ट फॉर द सेक लेट मी पुट वन इंडिकेटर हियर, ठीक है।
व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ दिस सेकंड डाउन एरो?
दिस वन,
यस सर।
Suppose you are making one second order system, d square y upon dt square, right?
Yes, yes, yes.
So where, what will be the definition of that d square y upon dt square? That yk minus twice yk minus 1, y of k minus 1 plus yk minus 2 divided by सम डेल्टा टी स्क्वायर ना, ऐसा कुछ होगा ना लगभग? तो वहां पे आपको सेकंड भी तो चाहिए होगा ना, तो द सेकंड वन हु विल गिव दैट, सेकंड वन विल बी yk माइनस 2 विल बी यू, ठीक है।
सो सर वी हैव सिंपली डुप्लीकेटेड द अबव,
नो दैट इज एड एलिमेंट, दैट इज थ्रू एड एलिमेंट ओनली।
Sir, can you show me how you have done that again?
Just I'll remove that. Just see this. This is a combination. Can you see? If I'll remove
yes,
one,
sir.
To the delete button, I cannot remove now. I'll have to right click. Then I'll have to, they have the, again another thing. Add element, remove element, remove all. So remove element, if I'll put, I'll be getting that. Again, I am showing you this add element. I have got this. ठीक है, इसको हटा दो, ठीक है, ये हो गया ना। आप ये देखिए, एक बार देख लीजिए इसको, this you will be liking it, this numeric tree, ठीक है। अब बताओ, अब let me put some value here, मान लो 10 रखा, अब बताओ क्या क्या वैल्यूज आएंगे। देखो ये न्यूमेरिक टू और न्यूमेरिक थ्री पे ध्यान देना, न्यूमेरिक टू और न्यूमेरिक थ्री पे ध्यान देना, ठीक है। इस न्यूमेरिक को तो हटा ही देते हैं, अभी कंफ्यूज कर रहा है, ठीक है, इसको हटा दो। तो न्यूमेरिक टू, न्यूमेरिक टू इज योर वाई के माइनस वन, न्यूमेरिक थ्री इज योर, ठीक है। नाउ द दिस इज योर, दिस इज योर वाई के, मान लो दिस इज योर वाई, वाई के माइनस वन एंड दिस इज योर वाई के माइनस टू, वाई के माइनस टू, ठीक है। नाउ जस्ट टेल मी व्हाट विल बी द वैल्यू एट द इंस्टेंस वन, what will be the value of yk? 10. And what will be the yk minus 1 and yk minus 2? 0, 0. In the next instance, what will be the value of yk minus 1? 10. And the summation will be 10 plus 10, 20. And yk minus 2 will be still 0. Okay, dekho. 20, 10, 0, देखो अब देखो, तब में 10, 10 का गैप है ना, दिखा नहीं दिखा? 10 टाइम्स करते हैं, देखिएगा, इसको 3000 कर देते हैं। Got it, this? Just I'll show you that suppose create indicator. Anyway, okay, now let us see another one important. So the loop is fine, the shift register also you have understood, okay. Now let us see one important aspect is the case structures, okay. Go to the block diagram, go to the block diagram and then go to the structures and then click on the case structure. Now what can you see the different things? What is this? Is a case structure. What is this? This is selector level, okay, and this is your case selector, okay. This is your case selector. Suppose you create one case, create a control. So the boolean. The boolean has true false. So can you see this? If you click here, it will be true false. By default, it is true. And then it can be true or false. Okay. Let us put one. If it is true, then it should add. Okay, if it is true, then it should add two numbers, create, sorry.
Sir, this is a case selector.
This is a case selector.
Sir, from where you are taking this?
Right click on the block diagram, go to structures, then it is a case structure. So can you see one question mark here on the left arm?
Yes, sir.
So that is the case selector. We will show, I'm starting with the Boolean type, right? If it is true, then so Boolean has two cases, right? One is true, other one is false. So it has automatically taken that, right? It has taken. Now can you see the selector level on the top? It is coming. Can you see this true false? The down button I am using, true false, it is showing. So here what I am doing, I am create control X plus Y, then create control escape, then okay. And now can you see here it is some void is there inside the why? So you know, because I have not made connection for the other case, right? For the false case I have not made connection, right? So what I'll do, I'll copy this control C, I'll go to false case and then I'll paste it. It has going out, I'll drag it inside, right? Now I want to subtract, so I'll click on the add function node, right click there, numeric palette I'll go, and I'll simply say I'll change it to subtract. Okay, I have to change it. Okay. Now I'll just connect this. This has got filter. Got it? Now can you see I have connected for both? Here I'll take the create indicator. Yes. So I'll take the values of X and Y as 10 and 15. And I'll take the value of X2 and Y2 as 20 and 30. So if it is now, what is the present condition? Present condition is false, right? Then what should be the value? It should come minus 10. Okay. Now if I turn it on and then I execute, then what is the condition? Boolean, what is the condition? True. What it should give? 25. It is giving 25. Is it fine, everyone? I'll put control U, make it compact. Let me try one more.
Sir, it is like an if else.
Ha, that is if else on that. I'll put more
kind case. Of if else, not exactly if else.
Ha, that if the case is true, then that will execute. If the other case is true, that will execute.
Yes. Sir, now, we can add if else over here by right-clicking and see Boolean palette is already there.
Now so, let us see one particular, like you know that suppose you want to give. Now, have you seen that what kind of generally we take the variable values as numeric or Boolean? Yes or no? That logical will take Boolean, that then the numeric will take. Okay? Suppose, do you take a string also as some variable? Very rarely, right? Because the numeric are very easy to, you know, compare or something. It is quite easy for us to handle. So let us see. Suppose we have certain this string type of input. Then how to convert, give a numeric representation to that. Let us see. Suppose I make one constant that is called ring or enum kind. Ring or enum kind. What is this? In the ring or enum kind, suppose I will create the variable as add or subtract. Okay. But and then I will assign them to the value of 0, 1. We'll show you how. Suppose I have created ring. Okay. Now go to the properties. Go to the properties of this. Can you see this on edit items? Go to edit items. Now these are the values. Okay. I will write here
Hello.
Add. Yes.
Hello.
Yes.
Sir, can you please repeat what you've just taught in the last 5 minutes? My connection got broken.
Yes, what I'm saying that we are doing this case structure, right? So for the present case structure, we have taken the case selector as a Boolean type. Suppose we take some string type of when I say add, then it should add. When I say the subtract, it should subtract. Now that the string type of variables are actually difficult to process. So what we'll do, we'll assign some numeric values to those strings and then we'll use that to our advantage in the programming. So for that, LabVIEW allows one control that is ring or enum kind. Ring and enum kind. Okay? So like this, suppose I'm using the text ring, okay? Text ring, I have computed here, text ring, okay? So I'll right click here, go to properties. Here, the data type, you can, data types appearance, that data entry, don't worry about all this. Go to edit items. Go to edit items. Suppose I'll say add. Add if its value is zero, insert add is subtract is zero. So okay, okay, this is okay. So what it means, just you see here, it is taking what value? Add, subtract, yes or no? So let me create one data, one case structure, put here. And what I'll do, I'll select this. So can you see the selector level, what is coming here? 0, 1. Yes or no? Now, actually, what you know that in the selector level, if you'll right click, then you can make some other as make this case zero default. Make this case. Earlier zero default, now I have changed to one I have given for addition. So then I'll add here the variables, create a control. And then I'll create control here. And I'll add here, create indicator. I'll keep it inside this city. Then go to again memory. So I'll create control. I'll create. Create indicator. Right. I'll remove this for time. Let us take some values. 3 by 3. Come here. The answer if I said the key. Yes, thank you. It has given me the value of 20. It is still sum is 0. Yes or no? Let me change the to add. You just see actually think this giving me 30. Yes or no? The general time of the instruction. How you'll get the string is in the variable. Stop this thing sharing. Can I stop? Have you understood this?
Sir? Sir? Sir, can you tell about how to give command in ring?
Achha. Is my screen share is visible to you?
Yes, sir.
It's visible to you, no? Yes, sir. I'm not able to see. Okay, it has gone down. Okay, so just you see, right click, go to front panel, right click, then this row number 3, column 1, then text string.
Sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
So that you select. Right? Now come to the block diagram, go to the prop, right click on that, go to the properties, go to the edit items, suppose appearance, data type, data entry, display format, edit items. ठीक है एडिट आइटम्स में मान लो आपने ऐड सब्ट्रैक्ट मल्टीप्लाई डिवाइड सारा रख लिया ओके
यस सर.
So now this case, this ring has four values. Okay, it can take add, subtract, multiply, divide. Okay, now the user will be seeing only these four values. Okay, but inside this add has been given how much value? Add has been given the value of 3.
Yes, sir.
Just you see the numeric representation, you just see the add is occupying the value of 3, the subtract 2, the multiply 1 and divide 0. These are the numeric representation. Okay, so when I'll make one case structure, and when I select this, it is showing true, false, none. Now it will automatically change. Can you see? Now it is showing only 2, na? So you have to, what you'll have to do? Add case after. Can you see what I have done? It is showing 3 only, na? One more it should come, na? One more. So I'll move one case, add case after. So now it is complete. All the 4 cases are there. 0, 1, 2, 3. Yes, 4 only na cases. Acha, abhi jara sa hi atpata lag raha hai na, 0, 1, 2, 3 kya hai? Haan, wo to ye dikhna chahiye tha na. Add, subtract, ye dikhta to achha lagta na. है कि नहीं अच्छा लगता कि नहीं वो दिखने में तो
yes,
ये वो ना एनम से आ जाता है लेट मी ट्राई दैट विद एनम सो लेट मी गो टू एनम ठीक है गो टू प्रॉपर्टीज एडिट आइटम्स ऐड इंसर्ट सबट्रैक्ट मान लो दो ही वाला वो तो क्योंकि ऊपर वाला तो दो ही के लिए था ना द टॉप वन इज फॉर ओनली 2 ना सो लेट मी कनेक्ट दिस वंस हां देखो आ गया ना ये ऐड सबट्रैक्ट आ गया ना इसमें आ गया ना ऊपर वाले में देखो ये पहले 0 1 आ रहा था ना वहां पे रिंग वाले में तो इसमें क्या वो एड सबट्रैक्ट आ जाएगा राइट इनम में बट बोथ ऑफ देम आर सिमिलर काइंड दे आर नॉट मच डिफरेंस हियर ओनली द वैल्यूज आर बीइंग डिस्प्लेड एंड दे आर द वर्ड विल बी डिस्प्लेड ठीक है बट द मेथोडोलॉजी इज सेम अच्छा सपोज यू वांट टू डिलीट वन केस ठीक है मान लो एक केस ज्यादा कर दिया एक डिलीट करना है तो कैसे करोगे यू विल गो टू ए पर्टिकुलर केस 1 मान लो इसको डिलीट करना है तो क्या करोगे यू विल सेलेक्ट दैट पर्टिकुलर केस ठीक है यहां जाना देन राइट क्लिक ऑन द सिलेक्टर लेवल एंड यहां पे दिख रहा है यहां पे ऑप्शंस ऐड केस आफ्टर ऐड केस बिफोर डुप्लीकेट केस डिलीट दिस केस ठीक है ये डिलीट कर दिया तो मैंने एक एक चला गया ना आई थिंक इफ यू वी कैन स्टॉप हियर फॉर टुडे दैट इट वाज अ वेरी नाइस सेशन विद यू नाइस एक्सपीरियंस The session 1 happened for 1 hour in introduction, and Vineet, everyone was so cooperative that you have installed all the software so that the learning could be great. In the second, we have learned the basics, LabVIEW, all those. And in this session, we have seen a bit of programming, quite good amount of programming. Some portion that I'll request Vineet also to cover tomorrow that regarding arrays and clusters. So he will be some portion of that he will be covering on my request. Okay. Now, at least, are you comfortable with the LabVIEW? Suppose someone ask you that what is front panel, what is block diagram, it is the controls, what are the indicators, how the loops functions, what are the data type, what is the integer, floating point, boolean, and string type. You can make out from the color, you can make out that you know that a thin color will be if you have orange color, it will be floating point. If it is a blue color, it will be integer, like that. Pink color is string, and the green color will be boolean. Then from the thickness of the wire also, you can make the data quantity type, whether it is a scalar or 1D array or 2D array. 1D array will be thin lines, 2D array will be thick lines, and scalar, thin lines will be scalar, thick lines will be 1D array, and that two parallel thick lines will be 2D array, like that. Okay? So you can make out all these basic things. Then we have also learned about the looping, those aspects, for loop, while loop, that also we have seen. Then we have seen the feedback, that how to add feedback shift register in our loops. Those things we have seen. So it was nice overall experience with you on the day one. It was hectic, but no matter. It was very satisfying that because I could see all of you were practicing along with me. Any questions? If I might have missed the chat, I think as I said, I was on the my desktop, so that was the issue.
Excuse me, sir. So what is the difference between MATLAB and LabVIEW? Because using Simulink also we can carry out these operations. Then what is the major difference between these two softwares?
Simulink, you know that you have to write the data format, all those. This is not the case here. Okay. Then the LabVIEW, that LabVIEW is a for the test automation and measurement, they are the leaders, actually, the market leaders in many sense. You will be seeing a lot of data acquisition cards that we'll be showing you tomorrow, that how to interface, and you can make out. See, there will be definitely there will be so many that applications which can be done by this or that, but somewhere there is a ease of doing that. Could you felt like today ease of doing that? So when you have first encountered the MATLAB, and when you have first encountered the encountered the MATLAB in your first year, right, Irisha? So on the day one, when you have studied that MATLAB, and on the day one you have studied this LabVIEW, did you felt any difference in your own understanding?
Yes, sir. This was much easier, but more or less many things were similar, like the connections we were making.
It will be similar also, because addition will give you the same result. But the thing is, in the first instance, you are able to relate to that. See that in the MATLAB, can you make out from the simple looking at the diagram, can you make out the data type with the array, or you will have to look at the workspace, right?
Yes, sir. That was the drawback. Yes, sir.
There are advantages, there are disadvantages. MATLAB is also, no doubt, is a good software. So each one have their own advantages and their own limitations, maybe that. Okay? But one thing I am quite sure, when you have first encountered this software on the day one, this is only the session of, I think, 4 hours you have been doing this. But you must be feeling very confident now at the end of the session. Yes, I can build some application. And you will be more comfortable when you will be having some array operations or something tomorrow. So many things you will be doing, you will be writing the code on the MATLAB. So this you can simply, you can pass on the data values and you will be getting the result, the array operations. But yes, still there you have to give the data format. Here also you'll have to give the data in certain order. So those limitations are there with all the softwares. But see that to enable you, suppose you go to some industry where some project team works in this, will project team will change or we have to change as per the project? You work on the MATLAB, otherwise I'm not going to join this project. Suppose no, the project, no, na? So that that see these, once we have the too much knowledge, expertise, we can choose as per, and we are expert in all these areas, and you will have a better career prospect also, I think.
Yes,
you see that and you have to certainly move in the direction of your choice. Just see after 5 days how you're feeling with that lab view. I think now can we end this session for today with all your permissions? Okay, so tomorrow morning, you join tomorrow morning at 9:30 a.m. and we are going to have some more of lab view. And we will also have the visa that that we have talked for the instrument that control and DAC controls. So we'll have those things tomorrow. And we'll have one expert lecture also, Industry 4.0. So thank you. Thank you, everyone. So keep practicing. Come with more questions tomorrow. We'll be very happy to answer that. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.